In Paraguay, it will be mainly as a start, power used for Bitcoin mining. This is also what we're doing in Canada and Sweden, but we are expanding as well, very much so, into data centers for HPC and AI.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Johanna Thörnblad, Director and President for Sweden at HIVE Digital Technologies. Johanna, very good to meet you. Could you start by telling us a bit more about your background and role at HIVE?
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me. I am responsible for HIVE's Swedish operations. We've been working in Sweden since 2018. And I joined the company in 2021. At that time, we had one data center in the very north of Sweden, and we have since built out to have five data centers, now providing power for Bitcoin mining, but also expanding into AI and HPC, which is extremely exciting.
Tell us, Johanna, how HIVE is successfully using green energy to mine Bitcoin.
Yeah, so using green energy and renewable energy was really one of the things that thrilled me about joining HIVE back in 2021, when our chairman, Frank Holmes, told me about HIVE Digital Technologies, and that would be one of our main strategies to go to places where we can use renewable resources. And so in the very north of Sweden, there's an abundance of renewable energy, mainly hydro. We also have some wind power in the system. And so we've systematically just gone to territories like Sweden, Iceland, Canada, and just recently also Paraguay, where we can find renewable resources. And we think, you know, as a data center company, it is very important that we try to expand using green energy. We also do other things to help the you know, sustainability of data centers, and that is, for example, being the first data center in Sweden to help balance the grid. Bitcoin mining equipment is really perfect for balancing the grid. Within 5 seconds, we can essentially power down half of the capacity that is being called by the grid in order to balance that frequency in the net. And within 30 seconds, we could call off mainly basically all the power that is being asked for. And this is something that, you know, becomes more and more important the more a country or a region is dependent on renewable energy to have that type of flexibility in the system.
Johanna, you mentioned that expansion of your operations into Paraguay. What makes Paraguay a suitable destination for Bitcoin mining?
Well, so HIVE as a company is looking for growth opportunity. And again, we're looking for growth opportunities where we can find renewable energy and at a good price, and where we see that, you know, the regulatory framework, the governments are interested in having us join them. And so Paraguay has been very, very interesting for us. I was there myself about a year ago when we first started looking at Paraguay. I speak Spanish, so was happy to join the crew when we first went there to meet with the government officials. And so Paraguay is a country that also has an abundance of renewable energy, hydro energy, at a good price. And frankly, we see there that, you know, coming in, building out our data center infrastructure, that we can help the country of Paraguay and we can help our shareholders. They have a taker for all this energy that is available. And we will be paying in US dollars every month, which, yeah, obviously very interesting also for Paraguay and their economic situation. And now we started with a 100 megawatt project. We've recently announced that we're about to take over 200 additional megawatts. So we're expanding, from 120 megawatts to 420 megawatts total for Hive. So basically 400% growth here over the next 8 months.
How do the Paraguay operations complement your data center operations in Sweden, and of course your other global operations?
Yes, so we have data center operations in Canada, in Sweden, and now building in Paraguay as well. And in Paraguay, it will be mainly as a start, power used for Bitcoin mining. This is also what we're doing in Canada and Sweden, but we are expanding as well, very much so, into data centers for HPC and AI. So I think it would be interesting to see in Paraguay as well. Could this be a first stepping stone, starting with Bitcoin and perhaps eventually also expanding into HPC AI as we're doing in the other territories?
You spoke at the Digital Assets Forum in London earlier this month. Tell us about your message to the delegates there.
Well, the message there, and I was very pleased to be on stage with someone as knowledgeable and in tune with what's going on in Washington as Anthony Scaramucci. My message there was just that we think this is a very exciting time for Bitcoin mining. The new policies and the statements that have come out of Washington now, where we see that it's not only about what the Republicans have planned, but there's been a workforce put into place now that we hope is going to work bilaterally across the aisle, so that we can have regulation that will be long-term and sustainable into the future, so that in 4 years we won't start over again, but that this is really going to put a basis for long-term benefits for Bitcoin and for blockchain, for AI. That same workforce is putting some very good and important and necessary regulation in place.
Johanna, I hope you'll keep us posted on progress at Hive. Thank you very much for your insights today.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
That's Johanna Thörnblad, Director and President for Sweden at HIVE Digital Technologies.